The rappers and the cowboys has certainly turned into one of the most heated situations currently in WCW today. And this rivalry, Scott Hudson, is going to bash at the beach, because at that event on July the 11th, there's going to be an eight-man elimination tag team bout. We talked earlier about the teams, and this is half of Team Cowboy. Hennig and Duncum joined by the Wyndham Brothers against Conan, Mysterio, B.A., and Swole. And in that elimination match, when you are beaten, you must leave the ring. I mean, we could be looking at a situation where there could be four-on-one at Bash at the Beach.
Well, what I tell you, I like rap music as much as the next guy. I like country music as much as the next guy. But that song, every time they play that, there's not a fertile cat in the tri-state area. That thing will neuter every animal there is in sound. Please.
I don't know. Our broadcast colleague, Larry Zbysko, seems to think that it's going to be a hit on the C&W charts.
Great. Well, Larry Zbysko, great country music connoisseur that he is. It was written after 1912. He doesn't listen to it.
What do you mean? He mentioned on Thunder that Bob Seger is his favorite. He's a big rock and roll fan.
Larry Zbysko is a Bob Seger fan?
You're going to have to start listening to the Thunder broadcast.
Why should I do that?
Well, you might learn something, I guess.
From Zbysko?
He is wrestling's living legend.
The Cowboys to face Lenny Lane and Bobby Blayze. And I'm wondering, you know this question, where is Lodi? I can't believe I'm asking that.
Now, why would you want to know in the first place? But I think what you mean to say is, with Lenny Lane in the ring, can Lodi be far behind?
Watch it. Every time we see Lenny Lane, we see Lodi come to the ring later, and vice versa. But this is Bobby Blayze and Lenny Lane, and they're in there with the Cowboy. This is not a match to be taken lightly.
Yeah, I'm almost surprised that Lenny Lane and Lodi haven't formed a tag team. They've been awfully friendly as of late.
That is a slap heard around the world when it knocks you down. One right to the bread basket from Curt Hennig. And to the ropes, Lenny. Oh, big knee lift. Oh, Lenny was hung out for dry on that one.
Great execution of that move by Curt Hennig, the master of, wrestling technique. And Hennig unloaded with the knee lift. You see now his tag team partner, Duncum, taking Lenny Lane, crushing him back into the ring. But look at Lenny Lane bail out.
2 weeks from tomorrow night in Fort Lauderdale at Bash at the Beach, 4-on-4 elimination contest. The Cowboys, Curt Hennig, Bobby Duncum Jr., Kendall and Barry Windham to face B.A., Swole, Rey Mysterio Jr., and Conan. And you said it earlier, Mike, and that's what has to be in the mind of every participant. It could be 4-on-1 before it's all over.
Well, that's really the reality of an elimination match. You always have to have that in the back of your mind. It could come down to a situation where Rey Mysterio Jr. could be the solo man for his team against the four Cowboys in a 4-on-1. It's just going to be quite a matchup. And isn't it ironic that for an organization that was on the verge of possibly eliminating tag team wrestling, upcoming at Bash at the Beach, we have that eight-man tag. We have the World's Tag Team title match with Perry Saturn and Chris Benoit challenging Diamond Dallas Page and Bam Bam Bigelow with Canyon. And then we also have Kevin Nash and Sting forming a tag team simply because of Roddy Piper and Ric Flair's ruling against Team Savage, Randy Savage, and Psychotic Sid Vicious.
And let's not forget, you've got Miss Madness, Gorgeous George, and Medusa out there at ringside with Team Madness. That's almost like 5-on-2.
Well, we know they're not afraid to get physically involved, but by the same token, we also know that Kevin Nash and Sting, they're not afraid to fight back.
That's right. Hang on. Lateral press hooks the leg, and Bobby Duncum Jr. got the two count on Lenny Lane. And I wonder, talking about Kevin Nash, is he going to be distracted because of what is going down? Oh, hang on. One more time. Bobby Duncum got a two count. Bobby Blayze makes the late save. Is Nash distracted by the situation with Ric Flair? The surprise we will see Monday at the United Center in Chicago on Nitro.
I don't think there's any question that Kevin Nash has to be distracted, not knowing what Ric Flair has up his sleeve. We'll all find out Monday at the United Center, live on Nitro on TNT. And, of course, Kevin Nash has to be distracted by not knowing who was it that was behind the wheel of the Hummer.
Kevin Nash, an awful lot of irons in the fire, headed toward Bash at the Beach. Meanwhile, the Cowboys just uncorking on Lenny Lane.
And maybe the ultimate distraction for Kevin Nash is the mere fact that he can't even trust his own tag team partner, Sting, upcoming at Bash at the Beach, at least in the mind of Kevin Nash.
I was going to say, can he trust him? I don't think he does. I don't know if he has a reason not to. I think Kevin Nash is just getting paranoid because so many people want that gold around their waist.
Well, it's all about proof, and at this point in time, he's just relying on Sting's word. Sting denying that he was the wheel man behind the Hummer, but as we mentioned earlier, in professional wrestling today, you just don't know who you can trust.
Bobby Blayze has had enough. He came in to make the save for Lenny Lane, but the referee, Billy Silverman, backing him out to his corner. Meanwhile, Curt Hennig with that bull rope took the life out of Lenny Lane.
Not afraid to use the bull rope or the cowbell. The Cowboys always have that weapon in their corner. And look at Duncum send Lane into the top turnbuckle with impact and then just shrugged him off, just knocked him down to the canvas.
Earlier on in this broadcast, we saw Swole, Chase, B.A., Ray Jr., and Conan out during the Barry Windham Rey Mysterio Jr. match. You got to think Hennig and Duncum, they know there are reinforcements backstage. They have to be very careful in this contest.
And careful is what they should be when you're dealing with an association and with a group like the No Limit Soldiers. They have really made quite an impact in World Championship Wrestling in a very short time.
Baseball slide escape for Lenny Lane. He makes the tag. Bobby Blayze in there, but Curt Hennig cut him off at the pass. Oh, and Duncum now. Hey, there's Lodi.
Now, you asked for him. You got him. Lodi comes down to the ring, and he just pulled Lenny Lane out of the battle.
Oh, Lenny Lane has been hammered, and Lodi, there they go.
I don't know. It looks like he's taking him to the back.
What happened? Oh, poor Bobby Blayze. This is now a handicap contest with Curt Hennig and Bobby Duncum Jr. taking on Bobby Blayze solo. Lodi just took Lenny Lane into the dressing room there. Who knows?
Well, they just tossed Bobby Blayze to the wolves is what they did. There's the Hennig flex.
That is going to do it. Bobby Blayze can't fight two men. And the Cowboys, Curt Hennig and Bobby Duncum Jr. will win it here on Saturday night.
Now, Lodi and Lenny Lane just turned their backs on Bobby Blayze. They walked out, left him in a handicap match type situation. One on two, and Hennig and Duncum had their way with Lenny Lane.
There's that song again.
Sort of a toe capper, isn't it?
Yeah.
You can put the vocal track out of your mind.
They would just turn the sound way down. I'd love this song. Curt Hennig filming the video yesterday in Nashville, Tennessee. No doubt we'll see that thing played to death on CMT coming up, I betcha. But the Cowboys reign supreme as they head to Bash at the Beach. It will be 4-on-4. Cowboys and rappers along with the No Limit Soldiers.
And Monday on Nitro, we will get the answer to our question. What is Ric Flair's surprise for the world's heavyweight champion, Kevin Nash?
Could it be someone from within WCW, from another organization, from Kevin Nash's past? We don't know. We'll find out Monday on Nitro. For Mike today, I'm Scott Hudson. See you next week.
One thing I hate is a bunch of crap.